very busy down there.
We got the toddler.
Thank you for joining us for Wings and
Adderall.
Remember, together we can help ensure amazing sights like you remain in wild places.
Enchanted moment, an
enough for this restless warrior just to be with you.
Soon, you're going to have a chance to undertake an amazing Navi rite of passage, flying on the back of this powerful animal called an Ikron, or as we call it, a Banshee. The way you're going to do this is by being matched to something called an Avatar, and I'm here to help you guys get ready. But first, we have to scan you for Pandoran microparasites. All right, everyone, stay on your number and move your arms a bit. Okay, start scan. You've all got them. But don't worry, they're very common around these parts. Let's start the decon.
Initiating GMR decon.
Stand still over your number, you're not gonna feel a thing. You're doing great. Almost done here.
They're all clear.
In a cage. We're trying to get in the sun, and you've noticed it's a nice view of like behind the tree. As you can see, the sun's obviously right there. Like got restaurants and stuff here now where you have to have like a mobile order or whatever to come in, which I thought was a bit odd, but I obviously said I just wanted to have a look around. But yeah, I guess it makes it more chilled, but I'm sure there used to be like stuff.
Unfortunately, So these have gone extinct. I didn't know that was actually a thing.
I've got a feeling they're called a capy.
Capybara, like
maybe. Yeah.
I don't
know.
Oh, wait, is it, does it say that it's called that?
What? It might do.
Dad's already read the sign.
They're way high up in the tree, so nice to see
them. What about it? Yeah, I know. It's so the birds can't get
out.
Aww. That's her son, boy. I can tell because his nose is flatter. It looks more like a pinky.
I stood at this class when you were born.
Damn.
They're both 7.
They playing around.
The father is down there. They're making it really bad. At first they were playing, now they're fighting. Dad's down there. Except for he's biting him. Flynn's biting Corey.
Oh, he chased him.
No, it's the old baby. She's trying to get out of the way. Everywhere has been so busy, but Dinoland isn't, because there's nothing really to do here, apart from Dinosaur and the fairground ride, so it's much quieter than the rest of the Today's drink, I've got the Irish cream cold brew. It's very nice and sweet, yet again. I might try the pumpkin cream cold brew one day, and I also want to try the vanilla cream cold brew.
Thank you.
have got the coconut pudding and the Kahlua pork with sweet potato and red cabbage, and then the fizzy pineapple wine. I've just got the Glühwein, which is mulled wine, in the Germany pavilion. And it's not that hot, but it's a good portion. But it was $9, so I would want it to be a good portion. Very cute little cup though, and like there's a cinnamon stick in it. We've all just had different bits tonight. Dad had the turkey poutine, and Hudson's just gone to get that now because he wanted a katsu curry in Japan, but it was a huge queue because there's just one person serving for some reason, like one person on the till. One thing that I would say is they are definitely understaffed here at the moment because we've not had bad service, but it is not like the Disney service that we're used to. Some staff are really nice and friendly, but some are noticeably how you would expect overworked staff to be, where like they don't have time to smile or be polite. They're just like blunt. Like Mum asked what teas they had at Joffrey, and she was just like peppermint or whatever. We were like, okay. But it's obviously just people who are overworked because they don't have enough staff. And also there's definitely a supply issue because all the shops have barely anything in. But that's COVID.